Today's workout, AMRAP in 10 minutes of American style kettlebell swings. Every time that you take a break, you're gonna owe 10 pogo burpees. The pogo burpee, I have a kettlebell here with me, but really you can use a line in the ground or any other object that you can visually see all the time. I'm gonna do a burpee facing my object. I'm gonna get up, and rather than finishing the rep by jumping and clapping, I'm gonna do a pogo hop. A pogo hop is jumping over that object or that line and jumping immediately back. So that would look like this. That would be a pogo hop. One more time. Notice I'm not spending any time on that side. That would not be a pogo hop. Your goal is to bounce back immediately. So, at full range of motion, a pogo burpee would look like this. If you want to scale that, this could look like a if you can't jump, that also counts. I'm still moving my body through space, and that's ultimately the measurement that we're looking for. Kettlebell swing looks like this. You'll need a kettlebell. I'm gonna step about a foot away. My goal here is to set up a deadlift. I'm gonna bend over, grab on, set my hips and my knees. I'm trying to sit back so much that I'm now pulling on the bell. I'm gonna lift my chest up, my eyes up, and spread my knees apart. Now that I have that set up, my goal here is to see if I can close the angle here in my shoulder by lifting my chest up. When that happens, I'm gonna hike the kettlebell high into my crotch, and then simply, it's locking out the knees and the hips so that I stand up hard and fast. It looks like this. Hike, stand, hike, stand, hike, stand. Note, when you see this, I'm not just going like this. I'm emphasizing and prioritizing the speed in which I lock out. And you can hear that, my feet move. But I'm not trying to jump. I'm trying to push the ground down so that I may stand up. Again, it looks like this. Now, that's what we would call a parallel arm swing. My arms are parallel to the ground. I want a perfectly vertical swing going all the way overhead. You'll see that the bottom of the bell points at the ceiling. A little bit of a greater range of motion, but my assumption is that if you're doing this workout, you've had exposure to this movement. Make sure you have a tight grip at the top so that that bell doesn't continue going up and over. I have 16 kilos that's above my skull that I want to make sure stays above my skull and never. So be mindful of your surroundings, be mindful of your capabilities, and challenge yourself accordingly.